Welcome. Today we will discuss cluster analysis in data mining. What is clustering? Is clustering is an unsupervised learning. It's a process of grouping similar objects into a cluster. That means those objects who are having similar behavior. A cluster is treated as a group. Partition the data in groups based on data similarity. That means we will calculate the data similarity. We will calculate the distance between two data, and if it is less, then we can say it is under one cluster. Clustering is also called as data segmentation. Where we apply this clustering technique? Clustering technique have different applications. First one, market research. Market research includes discovering the customer groups, pattern recognition, how much objects are together in one area, then data analysis, image processing, plant and animal taxonomies to categorize genes between them. We can easily categorize the genetic structure, gene structure in the plant cells using clustering. Then, Earth observation database. Earth observation database includes earthquake to find earthquake epicenters, or clustering those lands which have similar property, etc. Insurance claiming, identify the insurance holders. Information discovery from web, that means document discovery from web. Monitoring criminal activities, criminal activities which are having similar kind of features or similar behavior. Credit card frauds to detect outlier detection. That means it's an example for outlier detection. Who all are faulters in credit card payment. Then requirements for a minimum, certain requirements are needed for cluster analysis. First requirement is scalability. Scalability means it should be dealt with, the particular clustering should be dealt with a small database and also large database. Second one, ability to deal with different types of data. Different types of data includes numerical data, binary data, categorical data, ordinal data, etc. Discovery of clusters with arbitrary shape. It is not compulsory that cluster should be in spherical shape. Then minimal requirements for domain knowledge to determine input parameters. That means experts are needed to discover the parameters for clustering. High dimensional parameters may be, it is a complex task. Then ability to deal with noisy data, missing data, erroneous data. Then the clustering, incremental clustering and insensitivity to order of the input records. That means algorithm must adapt to newly inserted data, so that depending on the presentation of input, existing cluster should be adapted. High dimensionality. High dimensionality includes human eyes can easily determine or handling 2 to 3 dimensional data, but it is challenging to determine high dimensional space data, so it should be done by clustering. Constraint based clustering. The challenge lies on finding group of data with good clustering behavior so that it specifies the satisfied constraint. We have different clustering methods. First one is partition method. We will study it in detail. Partitioning methods divides the cluster into different partitions. Initial partitioning will be there. Then after this initial partitioning, iteratively relocate into different clusters. We have different partition method techniques. Some examples are k-means partitioning, k-dot partitioning. Then hierarchical clustering, different types of hierarchical clustering is there. Hierarchically decomposing the data. One of the famous examples are bottom-up approach, which is called as agglomerative approach. That means merging. Merging, first we will find the small cluster, then again small cluster, then we will merge the small cluster, these two clusters. Thus it goes, bottom-up. Then second one, divisive approach, it is top down. We are splitting, first of all we will find a big cluster, then we will split it into small clusters. Then density based method, it is not compulsory that all clusters should be in spherical shape, right? So we have to find out the density. Density means how many objects in a neighborhood, that means how much denser a cluster is. We have many examples, dbScan, optics, denclue, etc. Then many grid-based methods. The quantized space is divided or divided into different cells or divided into different grids. Independent of till now we had we talked about number of data objects. Here it is independent of data objects. Instead, it is dealing with embedded in space. Examples: string, click. Then model based cluster, we will make a model based on this model. This clustering is done, or grouping or partitioning is done. Then example is expectation maximization, EM technique. Then constraint based clustering based on behavior, based on constraints, we can divide the data into different clusters. Okay, thank you.